In this video, we're going to show you how to assemble Magore's Fiends for Warhammer Underworld Shadespire. Now, to do this, what you'll need to do is get a set of clippers, just like the ones I've got here. And then what you should do is have a good read of the instruction booklet that comes with the set, because doing so will get you familiar with how all the parts go together. And you'll also see that all the parts are numbered. Now, these numbers also appear on the frames and the miniatures, and it's to help you find the pieces that you need. The first model we're going to build is Magore himself, and for this miniature we need to start out with parts number 8 and 9, so let's find those on the frame. So if we have a look, we've got part number 8 just here, and we've got part number 9 just along here, so we need to remove them from the frame, and that's what our clippers are for. To do this, what you do is just get the flat of the blade and line it up against the part that you want, just across those little parts where it connects to the frames there, and just snip through like that. And then it's just a matter of working your way around like this, always being really careful so as not to damage any of the parts until the part comes away from the frame. So I've got this last one just on top of the shoulder plate, just there, and there we go. So that removed, now we need part number 9, which is this one just here. So let's cut that one out as well, starting out just down there, then on the side there. And finally, we've got this little point just on the side of the crest of the helmet, just there. Now with these parts, you don't need any glue to put them together. Instead, all you've got to do is press them firmly together. And what you do is just find the little rods that you've got on the parts. So you see we've got some here, and we've got some holes in the body. All you've got to do is line them up. So just take your time, get them into the right sort of place, then press together firmly, and there we go. With those in place, we can now move on to the next part, which is number 10. Now this is the axe just here, so let's remove that as well, starting out by clipping just on top there. Then we've got at the base of the axe down here. And then we've got on the arm here. Now on this one, just be careful not to clip off the little rod that you need there. You want to cut just at that point there. So let's cut through there like that. And with that removed, we can now put this onto the rest of the assembly. And it actually fits just in this point just here. So let's put that in there like that. And then press into place. And there we go. So that in position, we can now move on to the next part. Now this is part number 11. It's the front of the body just here, and there's quite a few contact points for this one. So these two points here, you can see, are a bit tricky to get to. So just take your time getting to these parts. So just take your time getting in there like that. And there we go. And it can help as well to turn the frame round and go to the other side if you're having a bit of trouble getting to it. You can sometimes get a bit easier access. There we go. So the next part we need is to just clip underneath here. And just underneath this part here, keeping those rods on the feet there to fit it into the base later on. Now we've got this one here on the side of this skull, and there we go. That part removed, we can now add it to the rest of our assembly, and it goes on the front just here. So we just need to line that up. It's taking our time to get it all into position, making sure everything's fitting correctly, and then press firmly together, and there we go. Now the last piece that we need for this miniature is the base, and this is this one here, part number 12. So let's cut that one out as well. It's a bit easier to get to this by turning it around this way on the frame, because you can snip through easier there like that, and just there. And then we're ready to put this down onto the rest of the assembly. So we just need the rest of the body here, just lining it up. You can see there's some marks on the base there where the feet go. All you've got to do is line both of these up, and then once again, press down firmly. And there we are, Magore is complete. The second miniature to build is Zarkus the Blood-Sighted, and this miniature starts out with part number 4. So let's get that one first of all. On the frame, that is just around here, and it is the back of the body just there. So we'll cut that part out first of all. So be careful again with that rod sticking out from underneath the foot, because we'll need that to fit the miniature into the base. So instead we just clip just there. Then we've got to go down the side of the body. So just there, and then just there. And finally we've got this contact point on the side of the crest of the helmet. So just there. There we go. Then we're going to need part number 5, and this is the axe. So it's this one just here, only two contact points to clip through. So we've got this one just there, and then there's the one on the back of the arm just there. Now to fit these two parts together, what we need to do is line up that hole that we've got there with a rod that's protruding from the back of the body, so this one just here. So all you do is just get that into position about there like that, and then just press firmly together into position, and there we go. So now ready for the next part, and this is the part with the gore fist on. So that is this one just here, part number 6. So we'll cut that one out now. So we've got this contact point on top of the arm, just there, on that arm there. And then we've got the one on the back of the elbow, so just there. And this one kind of fits on in the opposite way, really, from the previous one. Instead, we've got this hole on the body there, and it's on the back of the arm where the rod is. So again, we just need to line these up, just taking our time to get them into position, and then press together firmly, and there we go. So finally we need the base, and this is part number 7. So we're looking at this base just here that's got the single hole in it. So let's cut this one out now. Again, it's easier to cut the base round, out if you're turning the frame around this way. So we need to cut just there, and then just there. And if you look carefully on the hull, there's these two little parts just next to it, little indents in the base there. And these are to make him line up correctly on top of it. So what you need to do is just position him like this, making sure that you've got the little protrusions underneath the foot in the same sort of spot, and then press down, and there we go. Zarkus is complete. Our third miniature to assemble is Gartok Flayskull, and for this miniature we need to start out with part number one. So let's clip that out now. That is this one just here. So first of all, we need to cut just underneath the foot, just there. And then we've got this one in front of the hand, just there like that. And we've got this contact point on top of the axe, so just there. Now with this one, we need to cut out just here. Be careful this one, because it can be a little bit fragile on top of that crest we've got there on the back of the armour. But there we go. Then we need part number two, and that's the front of the body just here. So let's cut this one out as well. So we need to cut there. And then we've got this peg that goes into the base later on. So remember, cut underneath that. There we go. And then we've got this one just here. And with these two parts removed, we can now put them together. So for assembling these two, we've got these two holes in the back, and there's two rods on the back of the body there. So all we've got to do is line those up. So again, just take your time, just get them into position like that, and then press firmly together. Those two parts assembled, now we need the base, and this is piece number three, and that is this base just here. So we'll cut this one out as well. Got this contact point just here, and then we've got another one just here. With that removed, we can add it to the rest of the assembly. So we just need to line the miniature up with those two holes there, so just there and just there, then press down firmly, and there we are, Gartok is complete. The final miniature to build for our warband is Riptooth, and this miniature starts out with part number 13, and that is half the body, and that's this one here. So let's start by cutting this one out. First of all, we've got these two contact points underneath the paws, so one there and one there, and then one underneath the front of the body. There we go. Then we've got one on top of the tail, so let's get that one there as well. And with that removed, the next part we need is number 14, and that's the other half of the body, just here. So we need to clip just in front of the collar. Now we've got two contact points on the legs, so one there, and then we've got one there, and there we go. So now we need to put these two parts together. So for these, we've got two plugs just here, you can see, and we've got two rods on that side there. So let's get these in position, making sure the body's lined up correctly. There we are, and then press firmly together. Now with that done, we're ready for the next part. Now this is number 15, that's this head, this half the head rather, just down here. So we need to cut this out. And as you're cutting the head out, just be careful of the frill. It can be easy to distort the frill as you're pressing the parts together. So you just need to be really careful as you're handling that part. There we are, the head is removed. And so now we can add this to the rest of our body assembly. And it actually adds onto that little rod that we've got sticking out there. So you can see we've got a hole in the side of the head there. That lines up on that part there. Let's get that in position, taking our time to get it lined up right, and then press in firmly, and there we go. So that in position, we're then ready for the other half of the head, and that is part number 16, and that's this one here. So let's cut this out as well. First of all, we need to clip just on top of the head, just there, and then we've got this part on the frill there, and then we can add this onto the rest of our assembly. So this now fits into that hole that we've got forming in the front of the body there, so we just need to get the rod lined up, and then pressed in, and there we go. So now all we need is the base, and that is part number 17, and that is the great big base just here. So let's cut this part out as well. We've got to cut just there, and then just there. Now, as you're putting the miniature into the base, just be aware that there are some parts of the paws already sculpted onto the base. You can see them just around there. So we've got to make sure all of that lines up correctly. So the rod fits into the hole just there. So take your time to get the feet into about the right position, and then press down, and there we are. Riptooth is complete. There we are, Magore's Fiends are fully built, ready to unleash death and destruction in Shadespire. So when you're building these miniatures, always remember it's a good idea to read your instructions before you start cutting any of the parts out, just so you're familiar with how they all go together, but as you've seen, they are quite straightforward to build. So have fun building your warband, and we'll see you all again soon.